Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and I wanted to do a review for you of the Stila Artful Eye Collector's Edition. Now, this palette came out during the Black Friday sale of Sephora, and this was one of the $10 items that were on there. And I wanted to do a review for you to show you what the palette is like and what it compares to. So the first thing I'll talk about the packaging. It's a cardboard packaging with a magnetic closure. It's really nice and lightweight. It's really thin. It's very good for traveling. You will find at the back there the colors that are in the palette, as well as the ingredients, so that you know whether or not you're allergic to any of them. Please know that this eyeshadow has talc in it, so if you are sensitive to that, then this might not be a good palette for you because it's the first ingredient on the list, which means it's got the highest concentration on there. Moving on with the packaging, when you open it, the same pattern or print that's outside is inside as well. What you will notice though is there is no mirror in the packaging, which I think is a letdown, especially since it's a lightweight one, which it probably contributes to it being lightweight, that it doesn't have a mirror. But if you're going to be traveling with this palette, you're going to want a mirror in there. Okay, and if you're going to create a palette this light and this sleek, then it's probably meant for traveling. I mean, don't you think so? So I thought, oh, no mirror. So when I was doing my makeup, which is what I'm wearing right now, I had to look at a separate mirror while I was doing this, and it would have been even more convenient if I just had it on there. And I don't understand why it doesn't have it when a lot of other palettes of the same price and caliber, like the sleek palettes, would be on the same price but would have a massive mirror and honestly better packaging, right? Anyway, now let's move on to the product. So let me just go through what the colors are. You've got light apricot, umber, aquamarine, soft violet, and ocean. Now I'm going to tilt this a little bit so you can see true to color what it is. So this is a very champagne-y, sort of bordering to rose gold color. Then you've got a brown. You've got a green over here. This purple is really nice. And this is a really dark navy blue that's got, all of them are satin finishes. There's no matte in this. So if you're looking for a difference in texture, you will not find it in this palette because they're all satin. None of them are glittery. None of them are too sparkly. They're just very satiny. Okay, I'm gonna swatch these for you. So this is, you see how pigmented that is? Okay, it's good that there's five colors and I can use my five fingers. So this is light apricot. Okay, this one is umber. This one is aquamarine, soft violet, and what is it? Ocean. You can really tell it's very pigmented. One swipe, you get that kind of color. I love it for what it is and for the price that you pay for it. I mean, it's Stila. It's a very good quality eyeshadow. What I do find about the quality of the product is, well, it's very pigmented. It's also very powdery. So when you tap your brush in there, it dislodges a lot of the powder and you can actually see it like fly off the thing. So yeah, this is probably the only drawback, because what's going to happen a lot of the time would be that some of the colors would mix in together because it just really flies off when you put your brush in there. So just be a little bit careful with that. And because they're very pigmented, make sure you tap off your brush before you apply it onto your skin, because it really is there. Okay, I've used three of the colors. I don't know how to do that. I've used three of the colors today. I've used light apricot for my inner corner and my brow bone. I've used the green as the very base color that I have on my lids. And I've used the brown here for to blend it all together and create a dimension with a crease. So yeah, overall, I like the palette. Would I buy it again? Probably not, simply because I've got the Urban Decay Smoked palette and a lot of the colors on this palette is already on the Smoked palette. But it is a very nice something for you to give away, let's say, for example, for Christmas, which is already finished, right? Like a stocking stuffer. But yeah, other than that, I wouldn't really complain about this. It's a good enough palette, but I wouldn't say it's a must-have. Thanks for watching.